Welcome back to Sunrise. Dr. Paul, could you go ahead and conclude your thoughts on the point you were trying to make?
Area of specialty.
I was saying that even overseas, you now see lawyers that specialize in even certain type of prosecution, not even prosecution generally. See lawyers who are prosecutors on issues of terrorism or financial crime and all that. And I'm just giving that as an example. Here, you cannot be jack of all trades and have the same level of expertise in all. Because in those days, our practice was smaller. But the economy is expanded. There is energy law now. There's oil and gas and all that. You cannot have the same knowledge in all this. So when you want to engage a lawyer, even for prosecution, such person should be sufficiently knowledge in that area of the law. It helps in the prosecution. Now, if you want to say, like the essay to the president was saying, well, once you go to law school, you could do any prosecution, you are trained. I agree you can, but the level of expertise, you may remember that if there are some windows and some good defense counsel is in the matter, the person will be entitled to that defense and could go home. The next day, his neighbor sees him on the street and says, they wouldn't even do anything to this man. So all I'll do is to get a good lawyer. That's the psychological dimension of prosecution. So what are we talking about? Those that should be engaged in prosecution should be those that are sufficiently knowledgeable in prosecution. Now, those that will engage in defense should also be sufficiently knowledgeable. We cannot begin to say, once you're a lawyer, you can do everything. That being said, the major problem for me is not just with the prosecution itself and the defense. It is with the investigation. Because the prosecuting counsel is not going to manufacture anything. He has to work within the law, within the Evidence Act, within the Administration of Criminal Justice Act. Now, the break we have between investigation and prosecution is the bane of criminal prosecution in this country.
In this case, are you looking at the police and the FCC?
Exactly. What I'm saying is, once an accused person is arrested, and those within the agency, police, AFCC, or whatever, can make an early determination that there is something serious here, and this case may likely go on trial. The team that will prosecute, at least a member of that team, should join the investigation team, so that the prosecution team will know what to look for in investigation and have that ready. So that when you get to court, you won't be having the vacillating prosecution we have from time to time.
Isn't that what we have now?
I don't think that is in place. If that is in place, that is what I advocate. So that there's no break of the chain. As you are concluding investigation, the prosecution is ready, they know they got all they want. Within a month, you take trial on a daily basis. Our trial, criminal prosecutions, should go further to be time-bound, like you see in election petitions. And a judge knows that in 3 months, this matter must be concluded and judgment given.
I think Makwe wants to come in. Makwe?
Yes, looking at the roots, I mean, the basis of this particular debate, I mean, the president's comment. Right now, it would seem that Mr. Nanabai is saying that the executive arm is to be blamed, because when we say that investigation is where the work ought to have been done before coming to judiciary, would you really exonerate some of your colleagues in the attempt to try and stall cases? Haven't you, as an observer, seen attempts by your colleagues to try and stall cases from proceeding in courts? Is that allowed?
All right, let me take the example that Mr. Obunor gave. We should look at this from the professional point of view and not just commentary. A colleague does not control the prosecution of cases. The prosecution is controlled by the court. Now, the court has the duty to refuse frivolous applications. Bench rulings, bench judgments are given. If I want an adjournment, or if I'm opposing the admissibility of a document, these are some of the areas. It's not really the areas of a stay and all that. If I apply for stay and the process is before the court can hear it immediately, deliver a ruling, and proceed with his trial or her trial. That's the point I'm making. So from the practical point of view, I know that some lawyers may want to take a trial longer than it should be. But it shouldn't become an issue that is looked at, oh, they're just going to stall trial or delay trial. Because there's a master of the court, which is the court, the judge.
Don't SANs take advantage of some of those?
I don't know of any. But I know that there are things that crop up in trials that you cannot just discuss here. You get to trial, there's an objection. You get to trial, there's amendment of charges. Because the point that is being put to forward here is like, prosecution is always ready. That's why I started from investigation to prosecution. Many times the prosecution asks for adjournment. Many times the prosecution does not have its witnesses. And we talked about the witnesses, protection of witnesses, availability of the witnesses. Have we talked about the court staff? In the fight for corruption, there must be dedicated staff. Are you aware that in some courts you get to where these prosecutions go on, the NEPA takes light, and the prosecution trial cannot go on?
So those are administrative issues.
Are you aware that the vehicle, the black money or what you call it, that will bring the system, the court prisons, should also be ready to bring the suspects? This is a whole thing. And I'm saying that a judge, a court should disagree and refuse any counsel that moves to delay trial. A court that is going to try someone for 10 billion naira. The judge is writing on longhand. We cannot have electronics to, as he's giving evidence, he's been recorded. The finished trial, the CTC is available if you want.